You found it. Your home for the best content on your favorite team, the Fighting Tigers of LSU. Do us a favor. Subscribe to the channel. Leave your comments below. Be sure to smash that like button. Yesterday in hour three, as we were wrapping up the show, we got the fantastic news, which is now confirmed by LSU, that the Football Tigers will in fact open up the 2024 season in Las Vegas, baby, against the Southern Cal Trojans. I am so stinking pumped about this game. I mean, I know that we're 3 years away, but I don't care. It's Las Vegas.
Vegas, baby, Vegas!
It's Southern Cal. It's a jab to the nose of this. What are they calling the thing? The three leagues?
That's the College Football Alliance.
Right. The College Football Alliance. Can I just tell you how much that I love that literally 24 hours after those three conference commissioners grandstand and have their little Zoom press conference, like literally less than 24 hours after that. Literally 24 hours later. The most recognizable brand in that alliance. I mean, we could argue it is one of Southern Cal, Michigan, Ohio State, in whatever order. One of the three, arguably the most recognizable brand in that alliance, says, yeah, we're going to announce a game with LSU in 2024. Oh, it hurts, but it's so funny. I'm pumped. I am, like, so many times have we sat there and watched LSU take over a town. There was literally riot police in Morgantown, West Virginia in 2002. In Blacksburg, Virginia, for the Virginia Tech game. Every town LSU goes to, even towns that should know better, like Atlanta, bars end up empty, concession stands, kegs are floated. Nobody knows how to handle LSU fans except two cities. Two cities in this country can handle LSU fans. New Orleans, because, well, they know. And number two, of course, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Vegas, baby, Vegas!
I am so jacked up about this. There's a lot of things that I do like about the matchup. And again, the news had broken yesterday, and we now kind of have, you know, formal word from LSU that they are going to play in the Vegas Kickoff Classic 2024. It'll be August 31st. So a couple of things here. Number one, good on LSU for listening to their fans. LSU had gotten into this pattern of the preseason kickoff game. And I know this is one of them, but bear with me. Go back to 2010, they played North Carolina. 2011, they played Oregon. 2012, they played... that was the return trip from Washington, was 2012. In 2013, they played TCU in Arlington. In 2014, they played Wisconsin in Houston. And then in 2015 was the Syracuse game. They did a home-and-home with Syracuse. But yeah, 2016, they went up to Lambeau, which again was a pretty cool thing. 2017, they played BYU in the neutral site that was supposed to be Houston, got moved to New Orleans. 2018, they played Miami in Arlington. And fans were happy to see these games, but ultimately LSU fans got to the point where they're like, hey, let's play some of these in these venues. We want to have these teams come to Baton Rouge, and you want to have the opportunity to make these road trips. So LSU has started doing that. Of course, the UCLA home and home, the Texas home and home. You've got Oklahoma and Clemson and Arizona State home and homes coming up as well. Even a really cool game like Army coming to Baton Rouge is pretty neat. So, like, they've listened. But this is one of those outliers where they were able to double dip. They did it in 2011, which is the last time LSU played two Power 5 non-conference opponents, when they played Oregon in the opener and then went to Morgantown and played West Virginia. Prior to that, LSU hadn't done that, played two Power 5 non-conference opponents, since the league expanded in 1992 with Arkansas and South Carolina. I mean, 1991, when LSU played Texas A&M and Florida State, was the last time they played two Power 5 non-conference opponents before 2011, and then they'll do it again in 2024. So I applaud them. Financially, it makes a ton of sense. you're going to have a giant payout with UCLA coming to Baton Rouge, because anytime you have a marquee opponent like that, it's going to be a big day. Candidly, I was told last year before the pandemic, LSU with their home games against Bama and Texas were expecting to net $10 and $11 million in those games, respectively. So you bring in UCLA 3 years from now, that's going to be a big net money game. And then you're also going to play Southern Cal in the game in Las Vegas. And for what it's worth, those the kickoff classics, the money makes sense. Alabama, for example, is getting $5 million to play Miami and Arlington this year. So I don't, by 2024, maybe that money's going to be more. I think Alabama signed that deal to play Miami in 2017, so 3 years out. Whatever that number is 3 years from now, it's going to be beyond the $5 million that Bama got for this year to play Miami. So it probably won't be 10, but it'll be more than 5. So you'll get that payout. You'll get the big payout of playing a home game against UCLA. The fans get a marquee home game against UCLA. You also get a really fun trip to see LSU, USC out in Las Vegas. And then, I mean, obviously, there's the 2003 tie. When LSU and Southern Cal split that 03 national championship, and there was so much angst, there's still people riding around town with FUSC bumper stickers on the back glass of their truck. And so it's 21 years later, but we're going to get a chance to see that game and to see, you know, those two marquee brands on the field in Las Vegas is awesome. And look, it's at Allegiant Stadium. You get to go to Vegas and you get to play in Allegiant, which is a gorgeous brand new NFL venue. And that's going to be such an attraction, not only to go to Vegas, but to see that stadium and to see LSU and Southern Cal, to bring your brand out to the West Coast, to play a game that everyone in the country is going to want to watch on TV on that opening weekend. I think it's just it's a win all the way across the board for LSU to play this game against against USC out there in Vegas in 2024. Yes, I mean, of course you'd love it if it were a home and home, no doubt. But when you look at what LSU has done in the non-conference, this is almost like, because they're booked out through 2030, this is in addition to the really good home and homes and the good non-conference schedules that in series that are already on the books, which you have one for 2024 already with UCLA, and they're saying, okay, we'll play that game at home against UCLA and then also USC. The other thing worth noting is that there is a UCLA site. It's the Sports Illustrated's UCLA site is reporting that from the UCLA side, they've confirmed that the LSU-UCLA game has been moved to a later date. That was supposed to be the season opener in Baton Rouge, but it's now moved to September 21st. So LSU in that season will open against USC in Las Vegas. September 7th, they're home against Rice. On the 21st, they'll play UCLA. And then on the 28th, they'll play South Alabama, September, all of September. So that means September the 14th will either be, will very likely be your first SEC game of the season. And remember this also, if Texas and Oklahoma are in the league by then, you likely will have expanded to 9 conference games. And if that's the case, one of these non-conference games will go away. So either the Rice or the South Alabama game, you pay out that team and that game goes away, likely the South Alabama game. But just something to file away and keep in mind. So the UCLA site is reporting that LSU-UCLA will move to September 21st. So it'd still be played just later that month. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Please leave your comments. I love to interact. And be sure to hit the red subscribe button below.